The death-defying race for freedom comes to a crashing end. A carjacked SUV rammed as the driver realises he's cornered in a dead-end street. He makes a final dash out the door, but it's too late. With hands outstretched in surrender, specialist police swoop with a knee to the head, then punches and kicks rain down, at least a dozen, to secure his arrest.
The whole fence wobbled because he's just come through the fence, and I started screaming because he got out the car and I'm like, he's coming at us. He got out the car and ran to us, and then all these gunshots went off.
It's an intense conclusion to a chase that began 12 minutes earlier when our news helicopter spotted the Kia speeding past police in Melton. A 7 News cameraman was on the spot as the vehicle sped by, dodging a patrol car. Half a dozen unmarked vehicles followed closely behind, only to be led back down the same street just seconds later. The stolen car returning before heading off road and ploughing through the grass. The driver hitting the accelerator and becoming airborne. Back on the road with a convoy of police trailing behind, the pursuit and the real danger began. Speeding down the middle of suburban roads, squeezing between lanes and crossing nature strips without hesitation. But there was worse to come as the Kia made itself at home on the wrong side of the road. A police SUV came close at times but couldn't safely stick with its target. The wrong way driving became a pulsating theme. Heading west, he found himself on the incorrect side of a divided road, passing car after car. A brief stint in the emergency lane, the only hint of nerves, in almost 2 minutes negotiating oncoming traffic. Arriving in built-up Bacchus Marsh, the close call continued, but it became clear the driver was running out of options when the special operations group caught up with him.
The bloke's come like manging up past the footy oval. There would have been 4 or 5 cop cars behind him, and then they had like SWAT blokes hanging out the window.
That many police cars, of course.
There are at least 15. Yeah. Definitely 15. Yeah. And going so quickly.
We've got a man out in the public driving at ridiculous speeds. He's producing firearms. How someone wasn't killed here, I will never know.
The wild chase was sparked by a minor crash at Melton 2 hours earlier. The driver fled the scene, leaving behind his 2 passengers. Witnesses say the man pulled a gun and ran off through farmland as the dog squad closed in. It's alleged he stole the Kia at gunpoint during a home invasion, sparking the pursuit. A bystander was able to snap a photo before he took off. That image, a far cry from the suspect's appearance after his arrest, senior police defending the level of force used.
The seriousness of the offending, the dynamics of what occurred today, is justified at this point. We always review as we do, but at this stage I'm comfortable with what's occurred.
The 24-year-old Box Hill man was taken by ambulance to hospital ahead of what's expected to be a long police interview.